Hi guys, it's Matida Dead with the long overdue return of Mondo Squallido. As you guys know, I'm in Germany now, different surroundings, and I haven't done an episode, I think, for 2 weeks. The last episode I did was Sallow. But as you guys could probably understand, there's been a lot more important things to do. I'm settling in well in Germany. I already did a video on that sort of stuff. So I don't need to go into that one, but I need to get back into the swing of things, and so I thought I'd do another episode of Mondo Squallido for you guys. And with being in Germany, it was not a good idea for me to try and bring my films with me to Germany. So what I've done is, luckily, I've literally ripped hours of, you know, adult films to review for Mondo Squallido, especially the Avon Dynasty 80s box set, which this is a review from. It's a film from the box set, so luckily I'll be able to do, you know, films like that. And I just want to point out that the majority of the films that I'll be talking about on Mondo Squallido, I do actually own physical copies of. It's just that, being the fact that I was moved over to Germany, I've had to rip the films to MacBook, and so I won't be shown any titles or anything like that, but I do own this box set. And yeah, so that's pointless information, like, you guys needed to know that at all. So today's film is a film called Pain Mania from 1983, directed by Phil Prince, and this is a bit of a weird one. It's supposed to be a documentary, but you can tell that it's a staged documentary. It's a documentary produced by Avon itself, and it's probably Avon's most self-referential film from the, you know, back catalogue. And it's a documentary on the goings-on and the stars of the Paris Theatre, which was Avon's own, you know, theatre. And it's basically just a documentary that looks at the stars who, you know, are involved in the live sex shows. And it also shows some of the sex shows as well. It's only a short one. It's about 45 minutes long. But to be honest, it's, you know, every minute's enjoyable. It's a perfectly paced film for what it is. There's really no artistic value at all with this, by the way. So you won't hear me, "Oh, but it's got some brilliant, you know, cinematography and the sound." There's none of that in this. This is just a plain piece of trash, but thoroughly, thoroughly enjoyable. And I just enjoyed every single minute of it. It won't be everyone's cup of tea. Some people might think this is really shit, but I really enjoyed it. And a woman called Bumblebee, who I believe was the granddaughter of the guy who actually owned the Paris Theatre, plays as a woman, well, as a reporter called
Nina Nookie, reporting for WCUM New York.
Really imaginative there. And she's, like I said, going into the theatre, she's interviewing the stars, showing some of the sex acts, and that's really about it. But what I really love about this is just how shockingly hilarious it is. The interviews are really funny.
Do you enjoy drinking urine?
Yeah. Oh, that's great.
Nina Nookie's hilarious, especially when she's given running commentaries and reaction shots to some of the sex acts.
He's actually sucking his cock through the bars of the chair.
There are some real you know, pieces of dialogue genius.
You enjoy normal sex?
Of course I do. What kind of question is that?
In this film. And, so yeah, at the start it's more interviews, then it cuts to some live sex shows. Some of the live sex shows are actually archive footage from other Avon titles. But for the most part, most of the stuff was filmed for this film itself. And so, that aside, the adult content in there, being that it's the Paris Theatre, famed for the S&M shows, so there's a lot of really hardcore S&M in there. Some of the scenes that stand out are Annie Sprinkles with her onstage brother as part of one of the shows, which is actually a piece of archive footage. She basically, I think she's like getting attacked by a gang or something like that, and then while that's happening, she's then forced to anally fist her brother and then continue to fuck his gaping arsehole with a big dildo, which is, for me anyway, it was quite cringy. Although it didn't shock me or anything like that, it was just, ooh. Yeah, especially at the start where you see the guy making a lube her own hand up. It's a sight to be seen. Other ones are, another piece of archived footage is Mistress Candice, who's got a guy, tied up to a wall. She's, whipping his dick, slapping the tip of it, squeezing his balls. Just being a real, dominant. You guys know S&M and bondage and BDSM, so I don't need to explain what goes on. Other scenes are a really funny scene with, I think her name was Robin Thorne, being fucked by David Ruby. Robin Thorne being his dog, and it's just really funny seeing David Ruby walking around with this woman going, "Good doggy, good doggy. Good doggy." Then he gets her on a chair and then says some really funny dialogue like, "Ooh, suck my bone doggy, lick my bone doggy." And then after that bit's done, he then says, "Ooh, you've been a good doggy. Now I'm going to fuck you in the arse, doggy style." Well, not in the arse, sorry. It's just some really funny dialogue, especially in that scene. Like, just repeatedly saying, good doggy, out of breath. Plus the fact that he was doing these really weird orgasm sounds. I'll try and include clips in this video to show you guys some of the funny dialogue in this film. But if not, then you know the reason why.
Yeah. Okay, doggy.
But yeah, that was entertaining. And the like finale sex scene is a scene with David Christopher, Sable Cruz, and Victoria Sand. And he's basically getting dominated by these two women. He's being thrown on the floor again. He's having his dick tied up, with like a leather strap, and then as they go on, they keep pulling it tighter and tighter. He's forced to, lick the puss. Just, again, typical, dominance thing. And that's the theme of it. It's like asking the stars, do you like normal sex? Do you like the stuff that happens to you? Like, how did you get into the business? And again, it makes for some really funny dialogue in this film. But yeah, if you like to be, freaked out or, I suppose, shocked, then you might enjoy this film. If you want a good laugh, you will definitely enjoy this film. It's not the most graphic or disturbing or anything like that, but it's got some good scenes that would probably be good in a mixtape. And if you're into that sort of stuff, then I suppose it is pretty good. But again, with a title like this, I personally could not get titillated by this at all, not just because of the subject matter or the fact that pretty much all the men and women in this were ugly and not very nice to watch in the business. It is an entertaining film at the end of the day. Like I said, it's a 45-minute documentary, and I suppose if you're a fan of Phil Prince, then this is like one of those, you know, completest pieces. But on its own merits, it's a fun little film. Got some nice, you know, shocking sex scenes, especially the anal fisting. Some people might not like that, but it didn't really bother me. Yeah, I'm not offended or upset by images like that. It just like made me go ooh. It was just a funny film. So yeah, that's my real lackluster review of Pain Mania from 1983, directed by Phil Prince. If you want a good fun, you know, tongue in cheek, forget the pun, with some real, you know, so bad it's good elements, then this is one of those titles for you. I enjoyed it. I could probably watch this one again, purely for the dialogue alone. And yeah, it's a fun little film, and I think you guys would dig it. So yeah, guys, that's my review. The first review from, you know, Mondo Squallido Season Germany. What the fuck does that mean? I don't know. I'm rambling right now. It's pretty late and I'm tired. But I thought I'd do this review, get it done for you guys. So hopefully you've seen some funny clips in this. If you've got any questions about this title, feel free to ask. I'll try and answer them to the best of my knowledge, although I'll be providing links down below. If you've seen this film, let me know what you think. As always, I love hearing people's thoughts on the titles that I discuss. And yeah, so if you want to check out my other Avon review, then Neil Before Me, then the link will be down below if you want to check it out, which I believe it was directed by Phil Prince as well. I'll probably be doing a lot of Avon films from this box set over the next few weeks with Mondo Squallido. And so yeah, hope you guys enjoy it, and I hope you guys enjoyed this review. And until the next time, guys. You're all awesome.
This is Nina Nookie signing off for WCUM-TV. Good night and have a pleasant tomorrow. What a cum shot. Lord have mercy.